Hello, Mark.
G'day, Dan. How are you going?
I'm fine, thanks. What about yourself?
Excellent. Wonderful day yet again.
It's great to be out in the open air, isn't it?
Certainly is. Beautiful scenery surrounding us, and we've got a great recipe, great food here for our viewers today. And we're actually making this wonderful recipe at about 10,000 feet.
Yeah, that's a lot of feet, a lot of shoes to clean as well when you've got that many feet in that you're dealing with. But I understand you've got a bit of an anecdote about this special product that you're going to be telling us about.
Well, firstly, let me share with you what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be making a Vegemite sandwich. Not just any Vegemite sandwich. Some of you may be wondering what Vegemite actually is.
Actually, Mark, what is Vegemite?
Vegemite's a native Australian dish, and the history dates back almost 100 years.
That's amazing.
But what's more amazing is what Vegemite's actually made of. And as we all know, Australians do like a drink.
I've heard that said, Mark.
So what we've got is this wonderful product, which is actually made from the, I wouldn't call it excrement, but the tailings, if you like, from beer that's brewed in Melbourne. This rich product that's filled with vitamin B and yeast and so forth is turned into this wonderful black aromatic dish or paste that we see today. Just have a smell of that.
That is delicious, Mark.
So what we're going to do is we're going to take this national dish, this national Australian dish, and show you how to make the ultimate Vegemite sandwich. Stay tuned.
Just one technical question there, Mark. Is there any truth in the rumor that the maintenance department here is actually trying to make a Papuan version of this Vegemite?
I've heard we've got secret footage, which we might be able to share with you at a later date, of people at certain workshops, let us say, around the place.
You mustn't get more specific than that. You'll get yourself fired.
Absolutely true. But there are rumors that oil and water separators have been used in this process. We are yet to confirm or deny these rumors, but we're looking into it.
That is excellent. Let's get on with the demonstration now of this fine dish that you've promised us.
Thanks a lot, Dan. We're going to start off with some homemade bread. Now this is a special two slice of bread Vegemite sandwich. We're later going to demonstrate the single slice of bread Vegemite sandwich. This is the more complicated of the two, so we'll go through it slowly so viewers at home will be able to repeat the same thing at home and get the same results.
Well, you do like a challenge, Mark.
Nothing but the best for the viewers. Okay, we've placed our two pieces of bread on our breadboard. Of course, we've washed our hands and done all the sanitary things required. Now, of course, because we are in a jungle, we need to rely on our leatherman to actually perform the duty.
So this is more than just a simple demonstration. This is actually a survival lesson, in effect.
Considering the remoteness of the location, you've really got to consider what you've got on hand and use what you've got on hand. Leatherman, Vegemite, piece of bread, you'll survive for days, maybe even weeks in the remote Papuan jungle.
Okay, on with the demonstration.
Right, first we start off with just a liberal spreading of margarine. This can be obtained at your local Hero store. And we're just going to spread that on only onto one piece of bread. A lot of people make the mistake of spreading it onto both. Now there's a reason for this, and the main one is that you waste a lot of margarine. And the second one is you don't get to taste the full flavours of Vegemite. Next, we go to the core ingredient, which is Vegemite.
And this, you say, is an Australian national dish.
Australian national dish, and one of the things that some of our overseas visitors have had trouble with is that we need to be very sparing with the Vegemite that we spread. It's not peanut butter, it's not Jell-O, so for the American viewers in the audience, please be aware that spread this sparingly, because its richness and its aromatic flavour can really come back and bite you if you overdo it. So we're just spreading it very, very carefully, making sure to go out to the edges of the bread. A lot of people forget this. It's just a sign of laziness, I think. A professional sandwich maker will always go out to the edges of the bread. So we're just spreading liberally, but sparingly.
Liberally and sparingly at the same time.
And that's really the trick, isn't it? To be able to be liberal in certain spots and sparing in others. So now we've got the basis for our sandwich. Normally you could stop here, turn the two bits of bread over, and you've got a wonderful sandwich. But what we're going to do is we're going to add that special touch which makes it the Australian Papuan version of the Vegemite sandwich. We're going to add a slice of wonderful Cheesedale cheese.
That, of course, would add to the nutritional value of the sandwich as well, wouldn't it, Mark?
Absolutely, and considering it also comes from Kraft, we've got Vegemite from Kraft, we've got cheese from Kraft, and the bread home-baked here up at an altitude of around about 8,000 feet using locally prepared flour. Absolutely wonderful. Just a tip on the bread, folks, to maintain that freshness, a teaspoon of dry garlic powder will ensure the freshness is retained for more than the normal 2 or 3 days.
Excellent, excellent hint.
And now for the piece de resistance, we've placed our cheese on the Vegemite with the margarine. What we have here, some spring onions, finely chopped. Remember to keep your fingers in when you're chopping to make sure you don't hurt yourself. And now we just spread them a little bit more liberally.
So not quite so sparingly then?
No, we can be more liberal with this because people are quite used to spring onions. Once we have that, simply fold the piece of bread. It's very important to take the piece of bread that does not have the Vegemite cheese and shallots on it and fold it across to meet up with the other piece of bread.
That is amazing.
And there you have it. So now we've actually prepared it. As we all know, part of eating, part of the fine art of eating is in the presentation. So what we're going to do now is slice our bread, prepare it, and then find a nice drink to have with it.
What about the garnish? Would one consider garnishing this kind of a dish?
As a matter of fact, we went to great lengths in travelling up the heat road to locate some edelweiss and a special kind of grass that only grows up here.
That would be discampia, I guess.
That actually is a scampia, and that makes a perfect garnish for this dish. So what we're going to do is slice our sandwich in two, using, of course.
And here comes the grip. Here comes the best boy now with the garnish. You can demonstrate to the viewers exactly how that's done, Mark.
Certainly. Thank you very much, Paul. Yeah, it's amazing. A lot of these food shows, I've found that a lot of the people working behind the camera, their name is Paul.
They're all called Paul.
I don't know why that is.
It's the industry standard.
Ah, I thought so. Okay, so first of all, we present our product on the plate. And always make sure that you separate it out, provide a bit of an opening there so you can then present your garnish to provide a little bit of accent. Now we only want the tip leaves here, they're the finest leaves, and we'll just cut them off.
Those are the seeds you're cutting off there, Mark.
Yeah, the seeds really add that, I suppose, balance between the the greenness of the edelweiss and the white of the bread and any colouring that you're using on the plate. I'd place that straight through the centre, and then with your edelweiss on either side of that. And there we have it, the Vegemite sandwich, Papua, Australia. Brought to you from an altitude of 10,000 feet. Thank you very much, Dan.
Looks good, Mark. Thank you.
Let's try a piece.
Let's do it.
Mmm.
Yeah.
Sensational.
This is, in fact, it's a survival kit in a hand, isn't it?
It certainly is.
Yeah, very good.
But I can think of only one thing better. And that is we need a slight tasting a beverage to accompany this, and of course this is a wonderful opportunity to try the new Bintang Zero. The food was so good I left a little bit there for left there for later on. So we're going to try this new Bintang Zero. Certainly got a good head on it. certainly looks like the real thing. Allow me to do the honours.
Sounds almost like a waterfall, doesn't it?
Certainly does. Once again, Bintang Zero. Hop. And cheers.
That is the perfect accompaniment.
It certainly is. Not a bad drop.
Thank you very much, viewers. We'll be back in a little while to show you another tantalizing dish from the mountains of Papua.
Next week on this show, we'll be bringing you one of the local dishes, a very, very popular dish up here, but with our own added twist, and that will be the preparation of Indomie or pop mee or 2 minute noodles as we call it in Australia. But for more on that, wait till next week. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.